Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning Coffee. Thank you so much for tuning in. So this is going to be a general energy reading for your Thursday, December 12th, 2019. Please keep in mind that time is an illusion and energies are fluid. So just because this is a reading dated for the 12th of December, it doesn't mean it absolutely has to resonate on the 12th of December for you. Also keep in mind that this is a general reading, so please take what resonates and leave what doesn't. We did have the full moon this morning at 12:12. At least that was for the East Coast. I believe that was the that's when it was fullest. So today is the day, the full day of the full moon. However, it was the fullest for us here on the East Coast at 12:12 a.m. Yes, which is really cool. I personally was asleep by then. But anyway, so we're feeling through these energies. We're moving through it. I hope you guys are doing well with it. I forgot that the full moon was coming up. Like, I knew we had something coming, but I didn't realize it was coming up so quickly, or it was like happening right now. And you know, the purging that I was dealing with, it makes a lot of sense in terms of what the full moon was, because the full moon, it was in Gemini, and Gemini is my midheaven. So that's really how I, you know, how I relate to other people, basically. It could also be like my work and whatnot, but it's really about how I relate to people. And I was purging out some shit surrounding how I relate to people. So that was really nice. Okay, so let's get into the pre-shuffle energies here. So the two cards that have fallen out is the King of Cups with the King of Pentacles with the Seven of Cups. Are we gonna focus? We're playing this game, here we go. All right, so the King of Pentacles with the Seven of Cups. Overall energy, we have the Empress. Come on, focus. You have the Empress. On the other side, you've got the Six of Pentacles. So, okay, what I'm hearing here is this is masculine energy. This is masculine energy. Now, we could be talking to the masculines out there. We could also be talking about referring to the masculine energy within you. What I saw when I sat down and started to channel, you know, started to connect with the collective and started to just allow the messages to come forward and connect, the first thing I saw was green was the heart chakra. And lately, for those of you that have been following along, the colors for the collective that I've been picking up on were predominantly yellow. But then there was a mixture of green in that. And I was talking about how this is a time period where we are in the process of realigning our will with our heart chakras. So we're also kind of realigning our willpower with divine will in many cases. And there's a lot of purging and healing happening in terms of masculinity. And the way we portray ourselves in the world, the twisted sense of masculine energy and the twisted sense of masculinity that is dominant in our society. Please don't mind me. I'm organizing as I'm channeling this. My Virgo rising is showing. Anyway, the ways that our predominantly masculine society, but also twisted, okay, masculinity, has the ways that has affected us in our lives, and how to heal from that, how to grow from that, and how to integrate our masculine energies with our feminine energies. The first thing I saw in color today was green, and I was like, oh wow, that's great. We finally shifted into our heart chakras. Not so fast, Eric, because then as soon as I started shuffling, it slipped back down into the yellow, which is that masculine energy again. So I was like, okay, well no, that's fine, that's okay. But so with this, you have the King of Pentacles here, right? The King of Pentacles is very solid in himself. He's very secure. He's very grounded, financially stable. just an established person, well manifested, someone that really has the impression or holds the impression that he or she knows himself very, very well, and there really isn't anything else he needs to discover. Yeah, well, then comes the realm of emotions, okay? So, and it's interesting that this is coming out now. Maybe this is a hindsight situation, or maybe this is the fact that, you know, some people are actually really starting to maybe become pretty overwhelmed by your emotions, by their emotions. But what I'm kind of picking up on here is, oh my God, I have all this stability, I have all this material, I have all of this groundedness, I have all of this well manifested, and everything looks good on paper, but when it comes down to my emotions, I'm completely lost in the swamp, like this guy here with the Seven of Cups. And this person in the Seven of Cups, he does definitely looks like he's blind. Here, look, you see? Hold on, come on, let it focus here, let it focus. Come on, are you gonna focus? You're not gonna focus. Okay, fine, well, whatever, you don't have, there it is. You see, that guy looks like he's blind and terrified, scared out of his mind, right? He's gotten separated from home, doesn't know how he's gonna get back, doesn't even know where the hell he is, like doesn't know which end is up, okay? Overall energy, however, you do have the Empress, all right? And the Empress is feminine influence for sure. I'm definitely feeling that. And I'm definitely feeling like there are some feminine individuals around you that are kind of being a role model to you. And as you are in this King of Pentacles energy, you're like, how, I'm good materially. I don't know how I would ever line up emotionally with this individual, this person that represented by the Empress, or that the Empress represents, if this is an actual person in your life, could seem way out of your league. But that's not even the case. She doesn't see herself that way. He or she doesn't see themselves that way. That would be materialism talking, right? Okay. Also, what I want to point out is this green star. That green star, in my opinion, as the reader right now in this moment, is representing the green energy of the heart chakra that I was seeing. So this may not necessarily be an actual individual in your life. It could just be the overall flow and influence of feminine energy that is helping you pull yourself out of this stuck and rigid and dry state. What I'm kind of getting here with this King of Pentacles in terms of like water and emotions, it's like the King of Pentacles is like the earth, and the land has gone dry. It's like devoured of all water, all moisture, which would be emotion. Okay, come on, focus. Ugh, sorry guys. Anyway, but then on the other side, where is autofocus is on. All right, never mind. Anyway, with the other side of the deck, you do have the Six of Pentacles, okay? So this could be, what I'm kind of seeing here is this King of Pentacles is standing on this balcony with all of his riches, with all his material, and he's like, okay, well, how do I make this reciprocal? How do I... It's like a reflective moment here. It's like, okay, well, what do I do about all these emotions that are coming up now? Like, I have to deal with my emotions. I've never had to do that before. How do we do this? What's the game plan here? That's kind of the energy that I'm getting from that. Ultimately, guys, this is a good thing. You might feel like you're getting flooded. You really might feel like you're getting flooded right now. My camera really does not want to refocus. I'm sorry, guys. Anyway, you might feel like you're getting reflooded with this Seven of Cups. And there we go. Seven of Cups energy. But it's necessary and it's useful. You're not going to drown. Don't worry. You're definitely not going to drown. Okay. I need chapstick. Hold on. Okay. So anyway, before I go further, I forgot that somebody asked yesterday that I describe the crystals that I have here. So I'm going to clear the deck, and I'm going to, while I do that, I'm just going to talk about the crystals that I have. First of all, vast majority of the crystals that you see on my desk right now were donated by an individual that goes by the name of Stella. Stella hasn't been around. I haven't heard from Stella in a little bit, but Shout out to you, Stella. Thank you so much for all of this. This is just beautiful. But she provided these big crystals here. So what we have, this is chevron amethyst, a chevron amethyst orb. I love this one. Amethyst is one of my favorite crystals. This is citrine. This is selenite. This is fluorite. And this is rose quartz, yes? These down here that you see, these four bars, these are selenite bars. There's a selenite slab here that's housing a bunch of other things. And I couldn't even really like go into all of the little pieces that are in here. Some of them I don't even remember what they are, unfortunately. I wish I did, but there's just so many here that it was almost impossible for me to keep track. This also is a mala that was made by a client turned friend, Gabby. Gabby, if you're out there, thank you so much for this. This is beautiful. I really love this. So that's basically it. Yeah? Okay, cool. So with that said, let's get into the rest of the reading here. Oh, I chuckled when I finished shuffling because we landed on the Six of Swords here. I think that's kind of cool. There's definitely some movement. On the other side of the deck is the King. Yeah, is the King of Swords. But there's definitely some movement. Okay, 11-11. Whoa. This is good stuff, you guys. It's real good stuff. Okay, I'm gonna give this one more shuffle and then we will get started. Okay. Ooh. Sip some coffee first. Mm-hmm. Okay, here we go. Okay. Hi, Spirit. Please make me a clear channel for the collective at this time. Please bring forward the best messages to serve the highest good of all involved for our Thursday, December 12th. 2019. Thank you so much, Spirit. All right, guys, I'm going to give this three shuffles and then we'll see what we've got for today. For our 12-12 day, yeah? One. Two, and three. All right, kids, let's see what we've got. Okay, I'm gonna give this, I know that's a bunch that just fell out, but I'm gonna give this one last pass. And we'll see what messages, what's the topic of discussion for today. Okay. Overall energy. Ooh, well, would you look at that? The Queen of Pentacles. Oh. With the Lovers on the other side. Okay. Oh, boy. All right, we have the Star, the Eight of Wands, the Seven of Cups is again, here again, Eight of Swords, Ace of Cups, Page of Pentacles. Wow. Okay, we do have, okay, check it out. We do have the Devil here. All right, the Devil is right underneath the Queen of Pentacles. This is giving me a few messages. Okay, well, first of all, I just want to notice that with the Devil being under the Queen of Pentacles, look, you have the Devil and the Lovers on the other side. All right. What I'm getting specifically for some of you out there, there is definitely a feminine influence in your life. For some of you, this feminine influence is your mother or is a mother figure. Okay, there could be a situation in which a mother figure, oh shit, and there's the King of Pentacles. Oh my God, look at that. Okay, Okay, well, that kind of changes the narrative here, but not too much. It is entirely possible that there is a mother figure, a mother, her, an individual type individual that is in your life that is a hindrance, is keeping you away from the person that you love, is keeping you away from a mate, a potential partner, whatnot, whatever is coming in between the two of you. If that's not the case, then the devil is standing right in between the lovers at this point. I mean, we're going to disregard that page of wands. It's not really part of it. But look, looky here. You see how in the devil you have the two individuals that are actually found on the lovers as well? But instead of the angel standing in between them, it's the devil standing in between them. And this is literally how it came out in the deck. So you have the counterparts here, the king and the queen of pentacles, with the devil in between them. See here? They're holding hands at this point. So at some point, the angels, the universe brought them together. And then they were ripped apart by physical circumstances, potentially. Okay? Now, but see, that's kind of old news. We knew that already, didn't we? And of course, we could be talking about a twin flame situation here. If it's not a twin flame situation, then take it as it resonates, see if it fits for you. If we're not talking twin flames, what I am feeling is that the feminine principles, like I mentioned before in the Empress, the feminine energies are a massive influence here for that masculine energy. And it's like this Queen of Pentacles energy is teaching the King of Pentacles a lesson in compassion and understanding. Okay. Now, getting into the rest of the cards here, we do have the Star with the Eight of Wands. Okay, Star with the Eight of Wands. We also have the Seven of Cups again with the Eight of Swords, and then we have the Ace of Cups with the Page of Pentacles. I want to start here. The Seven of Cups with the Eight of Swords. So it's as if there might have been a mental prison that you have found yourself in, or that you currently find yourself in. If you identify, or if you resonate more with the King of Pentacles energy in this moment, from when I started talking in the beginning of the reading about how, you know, the King of Pentacles is learning how to handle emotion, potentially. If you resonate with that energy, then you have a really bright opportunity to release yourself from some sort of mental prison, from some sort of element to your life. Probably a belief system, it does feel like a belief system that has kept you from really tuning into your emotions. And what I'm getting specifically for some of you, maybe a lot of you, is keeping you from, this has been keeping you specifically from connecting with your inner sense of femininity, your inner sense of intuition, the flow, the flowy aspects, the softer, more receptive aspects of yourself. And I really love that the Seven of Cups came back out, but it came out on the other side because this is so much more of a positive side of the card. Because here you have, I want to call it, what I heard is salvation, because you have this angelic face, right, that is appearing out of nowhere saying, "Hey, I'm here. I'm going to help you. I'll guide you. Don't worry. Don't worry if you can't see. I'll be your eyes. I'll help you see again. Or I'll help you get out of this swamp. I'll help you." Okay, so if you're in that energy, if you're that masculine that's in that energy right now, please, please, please ask for help. Whether that's from somebody in the physical world, and I do feel like there are some women. What I'm seeing specifically is there are some women that maybe are friends of yours that you can go to. Now, it doesn't have to be especially, it doesn't have to exactly be women. It could be another man if you are male. But that is more in tune with their feminine side. All that really matters is that they're really in tune with their feminine side, and they're really solid in it. And you know, if you need help, please ask them for help. It could be a woman. It doesn't have to be a woman. I did see a woman specifically. So there is somebody out there, and there is a man. There's a man out there that's watching this that has some actual women that you can, that he can go to for help with this, for guidance with this, okay? But it doesn't have to be a woman. It could just be a feminine energy. That's really all that matters. But that was very specific. That's what I saw, so I wanted to mention it. If it's not asking someone physically in the world, ask your angels, ask your guides. Actually, do both. Okay? If you can't, if you know, you definitely ask your angels, your guides, your the ascended masters, your spirit guides, your ancestors, whomever you communicate with, source. You could go directly to source. That's a good way to do it, because source will be like, all right, perfect, I know exactly who to send. Ask for help there, but then also if you have the option, ask for help in the physical realms too. Okay, all right, so then we're going to move to the star with the Eight of Wands. And there is a common theme between the Star and the Ace of Cups that's over here with this Page of Pentacles, but I'll get there in a second. You have the Star with the Eight of Wands. Now, there is a little bit of a sense of urgency here with this, okay? Because of what this side of the Eight of Wands represents. This side of the Eight of Wands kind of, in a way, well, not in a way, it definitely represents a form of divine intervention. And it's almost a warning saying, if you don't handle something yourself, the divine is going to handle it for you. So I definitely see this Eight of Wands as maybe a minor arcana version of the Tower, okay? But this is kind of like that warning signal. It's like, hey, you got to do something about this, okay? You got to take action here. You have to take action. You need to take action. If you want to pull yourself out of whatever it is, whatever turmoil it is you find yourself in, you are going to have to take action, or some sort of action is going to be taken for you, and that may be less than what you would want, than what you would desire, right? Doesn't mean it's not going to be still in your highest good, but ultimately, if you really, really leave it up to the universe, you know, it could really go some way that you did not expect and you probably weren't prepared for, but you need it anyway, right? Okay, fine. But then you have the Star with that. So there is a little bit of a sense of urgency here, but I also kind of feel like that might be you feeling the urgency. It may not necessarily be that the universe is kind of like breathing down your neck. It could just be that it's like you have this vision, you have this goal, you have this belief. It's like you have this sense of faith that has been reinstilled in you, and now it's like you're getting antsy to take action potentially. Okay, this could be getting antsy to communicate. There could be communication that's necessary or that's desired, maybe between these two counterparts in the King and the Queen of Pentacles. Yes. And so then that takes us to the Ace of Cups with the Page of Pentacles. And the common theme between the Ace of Cups and the Star is that figure standing there. That apparition, this figure here, the male figure, the masculine figure in the Star, and then this masculine figure in the Ace of Cups. It's like, it feels creepy. Or maybe it doesn't feel creepy. It looks creepy. It could be seen as creepy. But really, it's like almost someone is watching you from the shadows, but mainly because they just don't know how to approach. They're not necessarily trying to be a stalker, but there's this sense of feelings of inadequacy, not feeling good enough. And it's really, especially coupled with this Page of Pentacles energy, it's really soft, it's really tender, it's really pure, it's very, very loving and compassionate. It's almost as if someone could be watching you from the shadows or watching you from a distance because they don't want to disturb you. They don't want to, what I heard was, they don't want to ruin your life. Maybe they don't want to ruin your life any more than they already have. That could just be a feeling. It's not necessarily true. It is, especially with this Page of Pentacles energy, and please take this with a grain of salt. I'm not trying to be mean or anything, but that does kind of feel like it's coming from a little bit of an immature place emotionally. It's like this person may be blaming themselves excessively for what they have done to you, what they have perceived to have done to you, what they think they could put, like the wreckage, the continued wreckage that they think they could bring into your life. That is coming from a lack of maturity, emotional maturity. But again, I'm not saying that in a derogatory way. I'm not saying that to be mean, because if this is you, you are in the process of building that emotional maturity. Because now we've gone from the King of Pentacles here, right? This King of Pentacles that was getting overwhelmed by all these emotions is like, what the hell is this? Like, I'm literally being flooded with emotion right now. I don't know how to handle this. Well, right? Eight of Swords. I don't know how to handle this. I've never been in this position before. I don't know what in God's name is this? Okay. But then we switch up the energy and we say, hey, the angels are here to help you. And voila, here you go. There starts your apprenticeship in emotions, in love, in compassion and understanding. Queen of Pentacles. So while the devil may be in between you two right now, and you know what? I'm not going to disregard this Page of Wands, because this Page of Wands makes a whole lot of sense. I'll tell you in a second. I'll tell you why in a second. But even though this devil energy may be in between the King and the Queen of Pentacles right now, and this doesn't have to be, you know, external counterparts. This absolutely could resonate with the internal counterparts within you, right? The masculine and feminine energy within you. That would absolutely be represented by the King and the Queen of Pentacles, because in the King and the Queen of Pentacles are like the physical representation of the husband and the wife in physical form. They are married. And so within you, masculine and feminine energy are married. They've probably gone through a number of divorces. You know what I mean? But okay, so you get it. So even though the devil energy may be in between the two of you right now, whether it's internally or even externally, or maybe even both, it's only a matter of time before that energy has dissipated or is eradicated, really. That's really what I wanted to say. Eradicated, and the two of you come back together again. The lovers. See how they're holding hands here? Divine intervention is absolutely at play here. Okay? For sure. All right, this is all part of the journey. This is all part of the path. Now, the other thing I wanted to say, I'm not going to disregard this Page of Wands, because the Page of Wands is like a minor arcana, in my opinion, a minor arcana version of the Hermit. There is self-discovery here. Rediscovering your power, rediscovering your truth, rediscovering your light even. Where the devil may have influenced you to extinguish all of that for favor of conformity and money, riches, fame, fortune, all that stuff that just keeps you burdened, keeps you locked down, keeps you chained to the devil. This could even be a situation in which you may have maybe sold your soul in some way. And you know what's so interesting? I was just watching a video by Ralph Smart, Infinite Waters, about how, you know, artists in the music industry are selling their souls. And there's three parts to it. I saw the third part yesterday. I need to go back and watch the other two. But I mean, that's a little bit of the energy that I'm getting from this King of Pentacles and the Devil. Now, that doesn't mean that you're a part of the music industry, but many people really do sell their souls to the devil for what? Money, riches, fame, fortune, status, drugs, sex, women, men, whatever, all the material stuff, all the corporeal pleasures, all of the pleasures of the flesh. Yes, not to say that we shouldn't enjoy those things. I mean, we are in flesh, guys, come on. But see, wow, we're going off on a tangent here, but that's kind of how the devil gets you going and coming, right? They demonize pleasures of the flesh, but then they sell it to you, and in order to really get what the ideal is for, you got to sell your soul. You know, I mean, whatever, that's a whole other topic for another day. Yeah. All right, so let's get into some clarification. Let's talk about the star here with the Eight of Cups. I want to do that first. No, sorry, not the Eight of Cups, the Eight of Wands. Interesting. Are there some things that need to be let go of? Are there some things that need to be walked away from? Aha! That really could be where you're needing to have faith. And it's like this Eight of Wands energy here is the is what? is the driving force, is I feel like it's like the kinetic energy that's going to get you moving, potentially. Now, there could be some sort of communication that's needed here. There could be, and that communication could represent some sort of departure from something that no longer serves you. It could be communication surrounding your family, maybe a mother. It could even be a father figure. This King and Queen of Pentacles here with the Devil in between them could represent your parents. Oh, wow. Okay, so some of you really could be in an energy of recognizing how caught up in the matrix your parents are and starting to realize the conditioning and the trauma that you experienced in life was directly related to how your parents could be wrapped up, or your family even could be wrapped up in this devil energy. I'm even seeing the devil literally coming through, working through, speaking through, acting through your parents as if they're like puppets in the matrix. Absolutely puppets in the matrix. You've woken up. They still may be asleep. Whoa, that was deep. Okay. So now let's look a little deeper into this star and the Eight of Wands here. Okay. Yep. Oh boy. Yeah. Oh, 10 of Cups is overall energy. I really do feel like this is reassessment of a family situation. The Hermit. Yep. Page of Swords. Okay. Queen of Pentacles. Wow. The Two of Cups. Yeah, and the Two of Cups is in reverse, you guys. There really could be a situation in which a mother figure is really keeping two people apart. Eight of Pentacles has fallen on the Eight of Swords and the Seven of Cups. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. So the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, the Hermit, the Queen of Pentacles, the Page of Swords, and the Two of Cups, which is in reverse. Let's start here. The Wheel of Fortune is in reverse. And to me, that's the first thing that I got and I heard when this card came out was stepping off the karmic wheel, stepping off the karmic hamster wheel, stopping the karma, stopping the karmic flow. And coupled with the Hermit, it's definitely that, but it's also getting in tune with yourself. Again, Hermit, Page of Wands. Page of Wands is a minor arcana version of the Hermit. Here we have the Hermit here, but it's the Hermit energy that is officially driving you towards stepping off of the karmic wheel or releasing, putting an end to some sort of cycle that just keeps going. And that definitely could be an ancestral cycle. Okay, absolutely could be an ancestral cycle. You have the Page of Swords with the Queen of Pentacles and the Two of Cups in reverse. Now, there could be a mother figure, a parental figure that is in the way of, you know, a union, a marriage, a relationship. But this also could be the individual that is working on closing out some sort of karmic cycle, is recognizing the relationship between themselves and the Queen of Pentacles. So this technically is probably the King of Pentacles, okay? And is watching the Queen, but watching from afar. And what I'm feeling is like they're watching and learning. Trying to learn, trying to understand. So I definitely feel like this is the energy of the feminine influencing the masculine, okay? Which has been a strong theme lately. You do have the Ten of Cups at the bottom of the deck there, which I love. And I really feel like that is the ultimate goal. That is the trajectory. That is what you're moving towards. That is what you have your sights set on. This Ten of Cups energy. Okay. So then we get to the Eight of Swords, the Seven of Cups, and that has now been clarified by none other than the Eight of Pentacles. And this is definitely a level of reassurance. You absolutely can break out of this mental prison. You just have to do the work. but you don't have to do it alone. Ask your angels, ask the ascended masters, ask your guides for help. Ask your friends for help. Do not be afraid to ask for help. It is asking for help does not come, is not a sense of weakness, does not come from weakness. Asking for help, recognizing that you need help and asking for it is a sign of strength, okay? This is beautiful energy. This is really, really beautiful energy. Okay. So, I think I'm good on that level of clarification. So what I want to do now is I want to get Spirit's take, Spirit's final messages, Spirit's final guidance, and then we'll get our oracle. Not sure where we're getting the oracle from today, but we will figure it out. Oh yes, indeed, we will. Last shuffle. All right, Spirit, your last take, final closing message from you, Spirit, in the form of the tarot here. Yeah, we're gonna do this. One, yes, two. Oh my God, there's that Eight of Cups. Three, and Judgment. Wow. We have the Knight of Swords here. So there's definitely some sort of communication. I'm definitely getting an energy of a knight in shining armor situation. I feel very strongly that this is energy of the masculine rushing towards the feminine in terms of trying to reconnect. I am getting a sense of urgency, a sense of wanting to protect. Again, knight in shining armor. However, what I do feel like is this individual, whether this is you or maybe someone you're connecting with, maybe your divine counterpart, there is an energy of needing to clean up his or her own space or his or her own environment first before they can really allow themselves even to enter their enter your life. Now, I did mention that there was a sense of emotional immaturity here with this Page of Pentacles and Ace of Cups, but this person is still mature enough to know that I need to keep my distance for now because there are still some elements in my life that are toxic. Okay. That is a deep sense of maturity, but then there's also a little bit of immaturity that's coming through saying, I'm going to destroy this person's life. No, no, don't do that to yourself. Don't look at it that way. Okay. But we do have, in fact, Spirit came through with this Eight of Cups, y'all. We have the Eight of Cups, the Chariot, and Judgment. So you have an energy here where someone is hearing the wake-up call, and I drew these on this pile over here, which was the Star, the Eight of Wands, then that was clarified by the Two of Cups, the Wheel of Fortune, both in reverse, the Queen of Pentacles, Page of Swords, and the Hermit. You are being called to awaken. You are being called to get into alignment with your soul, Judgment, and the Chariot. Alignment with your soul, alignment with your higher self, alignment with universal will, alignment with what it is you truly desire out of life, where it is your higher self is trying to lead you to, which is exactly what you've been asking for this whole time, right? But you are being called to walk away from some things, to leave some family elements, family business elements behind, and that's exactly what I heard. Okay, with this Eight of Cups, this does have to do with, for some of you, this has everything to do with leaving certain elements and certain dynamics of your family structure, your lineage, the way your family has been conducting itself over, first I heard eons, then I heard centuries. Well, no, first I heard centuries, then I heard eons, but you're being called to leave some of those elements behind. That doesn't mean that you leave your family behind. That doesn't mean that you're completely disconnecting from your family, but you are disconnecting from the status quo of the family. Yes? But this is all, but the reassurance that you need here, because I felt that come through, is this is all to serve your highest good. while also serving the highest good of everyone else involved. And if that means that you have to leave some certain dynamics of your family behind and no longer feed into that, that's because you are being asked to stop enabling these people. Stop giving your energy to these people. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that just because you pull out, they're going to really completely change their whole lives, but you're also being asked to not give your energy to that any longer. Okay? Let's look at what else came out here. Page of Swords, Seven of Swords, King of Swords, the Hanged Man, and the Page of Cups. So there is definitely some sort of investigation going on, or maybe there has been an investigation going on, or there needs to be an investigation. That's what I'm getting here. Page of Swords is the seeker, right? Is the investigator, is the infiltrator, is the one that goes out and collects the information for the King of Swords. So you're being asked to look at the deception in your life. How is deception playing a role in your life right now? Are you being deceptive, or are the people around you being deceptive? And you're being asked to look you're being asked to do some serious critical thinking right now, and to really look at this situation objectively and say, is this really serving me? Is this really serving my family? Is this really serving the people around me? Or does this need to stop? The Hanged Man with the Page of Cups. The Hanged Man is a change in perspective. The Page of Cups is emotion. It could be getting to know your emotions. Sorry, I'm trying to get this to focus. It could be getting to know your emotions. It could be going deeper into your emotions, trying to understand your emotions. It could also be an energy of needing to make an apology. But what I'm getting with this Hanged Man and the Page of Cups is you reassessing your surroundings and getting into understanding how you really feel about it. Learning about your emotions, re-identifying your emotions, re-identifying your allegiances, maybe? Changing your perspective on how you feel about certain circumstances around you. Okay? Beautiful energy. And again, I am going to say that this is mostly on the masculine side. So either you are a masculine individual, maybe you're a man that identifies with masculinity, maybe you're a woman that identifies more with masculinity. If not, this also could be, if like say you're more on the feminine side, whether you're a man or a woman, this could be something, an element that's helping you integrate with your masculinity. Either way, this is all helping us integrate both masculine and feminine, regardless of what side of the equation we're on. Okay, Oracle guidance. I was having trouble figuring out which deck I wanted to go with, but we're settling on the Crystal Mandala today. Because I was literally sitting here trying to figure it out, and I was hearing Lightworker, Crystal Mandala. And then finally I was just like, whatever, Crystal Mandala. Okay, fine. We're going to go with that. Okay, so closing message, Oracle guidance for today, December 12th, 2019. One last shuffle here. All right, here we go. Oracle guidance, please, Spirit. Oracle guidance for today's reading. There it is, right there. Card number 7. Angel Kaliel and Polychrome Jasper. Sacred play. Aww, isn't that cute? All right, card number 7. Ooh, I turned right to it. Here we go. Okay. Sacred play. Hey you. Hey you. There we go. Yeah. Okay. We bring you the gift of sacred play. We enter your heart bringing joy and an ability to have fun, to laugh, to see the silly and playful side of life, and to be entertained by the wonderful spectacle of life. When you know how to look, you will see the joyful hand of the Creator behind so many of the people, places, and things you see every day. You will begin to feel the Creator's delight in creation, and you will feel laughter deep in your soul and joyful connection with the universe as you realize that even in its strange and sometimes dark mysteries, life has a brightness and delight to it, a sense of humor and a quirky, amusing, enjoyable beauty. We know there is great joy inside you, and we will help you reconnect with that joy now, so even your most arduous challenges will not diminish your capacity to feel the light of your spirit and take delight in your life. Wow. Okay, I want to read this one paragraph. It takes courage to connect with your inner world, to go deep into the truth of your pain and bring love to those wounds, to allow a healing current to transform and free you from the past. It takes maturity to live with depth, to look beyond the surface and to refuse to give up on your journey when something difficult is asked of you in order to grow. To succeed on the spiritual path, you need this willingness to enter the darkness and liberate the love from within, opening the darkness up to receive divine light. Although there can be great joy in the resolution of such suffering, during the process itself, there may not seem to be much joy at all. Actually, I'm going to leave it there. Yes. Okay. So there you have it, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that was helpful for you. I hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I hope you enjoy this 12-12 portal, I guess we can call it, and these full moon energies. And I look forward to connecting with you again for our next cup of coffee tomorrow morning for our weekend edition. Yeah? Take care. Mwah! Bye. Hee 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 hee.